boy.
A terror. No,
as one of his managers, Justin's mother helps him coordinate his schedule, on this day organizing the promotion for his new CD. She was also there back in 1993 when he tried out for the Mickey Mouse Club. And fell in love with another young Mouseketeer, Britney Spears.
Take us back to when you were 12 and what you thought of her, what it was like.
Oh, I was, you know, obviously the feelings of love weren't as developed as they possibly could be.
At 12?
Yeah, so I was pretty infatuated with her. It was, looking back on it, it definitely had this great expectations vibe to it.
Did you give her first kiss, or you your first kiss?
I think so. I think I did give her first kiss.
In the Mickey Mouse Club or before that? Yeah?
Yeah.
Do you remember it?
Yeah, I do. I do.
Justin and Britney became a couple 4 years later. Britney launched her own recording career and, like Justin, became a rock superstar and a teen idol. They bought a house together, made headlines, and were photographed all over the world. Then 5 months ago, it all fell apart.
Justin, everybody has asked you what went wrong, as much as you can without my asking a dozen questions, because maybe you can just say it once and for all, and then the rest of us will never ask another question.
I don't think that'll be the case, but...
Okay.
You know, I remember when we decided that we were going to go our separate ways.
Yeah.
We sat down and I said to her, I said, if there's ever a moment where you ever need me, you can rest assured that I will be there because I love you as a person and I will always love you. But I also said, look, no matter what we say at this point, people are going to speculate things and I could really get myself in a horrible position if I was to say something and somebody misinterpret it, because that happens all the time. And I promised to her that I wouldn't say specifically why we broke up.
You've been quoted as saying something very bad happened. You can just clear up this. The impression is that Britney did something very bad that hurt you. She had a relationship with somebody else. Was there an incident?
Honestly, I mean, you know, we're not perfect. I don't judge anybody. I think that, it's just a situation of, it's just young love. It's a very intense relationship, that's for sure.
So you had your chance to be my lover.
Although Justin says that all the lyrics on his new CD come from his own experience, he denies that any were written specifically for Britney. And tell her she better just come get you. Yet when we sat down at the piano and asked him to play something from Justified, he chose instead to play a song that nobody has ever heard before. Interesting lyrics.
Thought our love was so strong, I guess I was dead wrong. But to look at it positively, hey girl, at least you gave me another song about a horrible woman.
The breakup with Britney has been devastating for Justin, and just as with everything else in his life, he turned to his mother for help.
When Justin and Britney broke up, and he has said publicly that he cried himself to sleep at night and it was a broken heart, what did you as a mom say?
You know, I cried with him and said, it'll be okay. You know, tomorrow will come. I just want him to be happy.
How's
he was heartbroken.
Put your head on mommy's shoulder.
It was tough for us. It was tough for both of us because I can't stand to see him hurt.
Can you imagine that someday you might be back together again with her, or is it a case now of just a...
That's so tough to say.
Yeah.
I mean, at this point in my life, if you really want to know who my girlfriend is, it's those 13 songs on that CD.
Don't feel me, baby. It's just Justin.
As we've said, the only song to be released so far on the CD is Like I Love You, which is in part about Justin's desire to fall in love again.
You're a good girl and that's what makes me interested. Hey! Late at night I talk to you.
Brittany has always said, and I'm quoting, good morals mean waiting to have sex until after you've been married.
I would definitely agree with her on that.
Okay. Did you and she live up to this during your relationship?
Sure. Sure.
Okay, I asked it, you answered, right?
There you go.
We both did our job.
There you go.
Don't you be my girlfriend. Since the breakup, Justin's been seen partying in nightclubs all over the country. He's been romantically linked to rock stars Janet Jackson and Christina Aguilera and actress Alyssa Milano. He denies the rumors and says he doesn't have a girlfriend.
What kind of a girl do you want to bring home to mom?
Somebody like her.
Aww.
Boom, got brownie points on TV.
Boy.
No,
cutting some slack now for that one.
No, I mean, honestly, somebody that understands me, somebody that understands the things that I go through in my career.
Physically, what attracts you?
Physically?
Yeah.
Oh, well, the first thing I kind of look at on a woman is her mouth.
Yeah?
Yeah.
It's not what mama's.
As far as body parts, I'd probably say I'm a butt guy. I'm not going to fight it.
Is that what you'd say?
I like some junk in the trunk.
Some junk in the trunk.
Yeah, that's a little Memphis. I had to put a little Memphis in there.
That's a lot of Memphis. Sick and tired of hearing all these people talk about.
For now, Justin Timberlake says he's content to put his love life on hold and just make music. And with the release of his new solo CD tomorrow, he's about to take a new and important step in his career, but maybe not the most important step in his life.
Lynn, what do you most want people to know about your son?
That he genuinely, deep down inside, is a good person.
What do you most want people to know about you?
About me?
Yeah.
I think I would have to definitely agree with my mother.
You know what, Mom? You did something right.
Thank you.
Now that's really nice. You know, he has managed to achieve the almost unachievable for an adolescent of being a self-confessed mama's boy and cool at the same time.
Mm-hmm.
Tough mix. The thing that struck me about Justin and Brittany, though, was during the breakup, with every opportunity they had, no matter whose feelings were hurt and how, no matter how many people asked about it, neither one of them ever said an unkind word about each other. Very classy.
Even though I tried.
Yeah, you did go there.
I did go there.
I didn't bring that up, but yes, you did go there.
Well, you win some and you lose some. And as a matter of fact, they go way back. Because even before they were musketeers, they were each hoping to be discovered on the talent show Star Search. We'll show you how they did, and you'll hear from the winner and the loser of today's newest talent showcase, American Idol. You'll see it all coming up. Stay with us.
When 2020 continues.
People telling me, you know, it won't happen because of this, won't happen because of this. It did happen, and I do have my foot in the door, and I am making a great album with people, so it can happen.
Next. Continues after this from our ABC stations. Wednesday, Barbara Walters takes on the Osbournes.
Oh, God.
It's Ozzy, Sharon, and all the kids, and you've never seen them like this. Just wait until you hear Sharon's stunning revelation that shocked even Ozzy and the kids, and meet the daughter you don't know. It's the Osbournes, unplugged and shockingly real, on a special 2020 Wednesday after an all-new Bachelor.
Justin Timberlake and Britney Spears get discovered? Well, even before they met as Mouseketeers, they were contestants on the same talent show. Bob Brown has a story that will give hope to thousands of amateur performers. As you'll see, the road to stardom is littered with losers who keep on trying for the big break.
Ready?
Take one.
Next.
Sorry.
We'll get back to you.
You nailed it. I got the part.
Congratulations.
Back in 1991, Justin Timberlake was a 10-year-old kid who entered the biggest talent show in the country under the name Justin Randall.
Help me, doctor, something's wrong.
No, that whole experience for me is very weird. It's very surreal.
Say, tell me.
The program was Star Search, emceed by one of the godfathers of talent shows, Ed McMahon.
Look at him. Look at that's working the group, working the room. And it's all body, it's all expression, all eyes, all gestures.
Being in Tennessee, I had been influenced somewhat by country music also, so we figured we'd go that route and I got beat.
Timberlake lost the competition to a singer named Anna Nardona, who didn't realize until much later that the performer she beat had gone on to become a star.
And then they told me, they're like, yes, Justin Timberlake from NSYNC, you competed with him on Star Search, and blew my
company. Britney Spears belted out this show tune on Star Search when she was 10 years old. Her competition was a kid named Marty Thomas.
I remember walking off stage thinking, you know what, she's gonna beat me.
Our challenger, Marty Thomas, who receives 4 stars.
And I was shocked. Shocked out of my mind.
Now watch me.
Any envy behind what's happened to her career?
Well, I mean, there's always going to be a certain amount of, man, I wish that were me. But I've never for a minute felt jealous of it.
Okay, audience, vote now.
Those elements of surprise, discovery, and even disbelief are part of the concept that keeps these shows alive.
Now, let the games begin. Our first performer was born.
Star Search really refined the whole concept. You know, it was the Army-Navy game, two people vying for the same thing. They want to thrill that audience. And it's like life and death with them.
The performers who appeared on Star Search, both winners and losers, make up an extraordinary list of people who went on to become stars, including Timberlake, Christina Aguilera, Drew Carey, Ray Romano, and Leanne Rimes. In this country, talent shows were a spectator sport in the days of vaudeville, long before there was network radio or television. One of the models for the broadcast versions was the Major Bowes Amateur Hour, which went on network radio in 1934. More than 30,000 acts auditioned in that first year alone, one of them featuring the young Frank Sinatra.
Who speaks for the group?
I will. I'm Frank. We're looking for jobs. How about it? I feel like I win
when I lose. Europeans have their own versions. The Eurovision Song Contest that gave ABBA its big break in 1974. Olivia Newton-John was among the competitors who lost to ABBA that year. Celine Dion, whose mother is Swiss, competed on behalf of Switzerland in 1988 and won. But what raised this type of show to a new and unexpected level of success was last summer's Fox television series called American Idol.
Oops, I did it again.
Many of the elements were standard, beginning with well-publicized auditions that helped generate buzz about the show and drew enormous lines of hopefuls from all walks of life, such as the eventual winner, Kelly Clarkson.
I was waitressing, I was working at a bookstore, and I was also telemarketing at this time, I think. I had 3 different jobs.
Other elements were modern variations on the talent show formula.
That was a copycat performance, not good enough, and you will not win the show.
For instance, Major Bowes had a gong that let contestants know they weren't going to make it any further.
I don't believe Cassandra has a singing talent.
American Idol has Simon Cowell.
My point is, you were terrible.
Excuse me?
The Prince of Darkness himself, Simon Cowell.
Cowell became a household name himself for his sometimes merciless comments as a member of the panel of judges.
In my opinion, that was dreadful. If you want to pursue a career in the music business, don't.
The producers of the show, based on a model that originated in England, made a deliberate decision not to pretend that everyone's a winner.
So often with talent searches and talent shows, judges don't want to be critical. They just want to say, oh, good job, and if you wear a nice dress, I'm sure you're going to be a star. That's not what American Idol's about.
I can honestly say you are the worst singer in America. Truthfully...
That's my first audition, so...
Well, I'm not surprised, and it should be your last.
People were in part attracted to that sort of nastiness, of course. I mean, that's what people... made people really turn their heads in the beginning.
And one of the things that hooked them was that the viewers made the ultimate decision.
The results of your vote, America. Tamira. You are eliminated this week.
Over the course of the summer, 100 million votes were cast.
RJ.
Which guaranteed the show would be renewed for another series of competitions.
Have been eliminated tonight. Justin. My friend, you're safe.
Contestants were eliminated until it got down to the final two, Clarkson and Justin Guarini.
The winner of American Idol 2002 is...
On this last night, there were 15 million votes.
Kelly Clarkson.
Winner Kelly Clarkson got a $1 million recording contract and a manager.
It's been complete nonstop. I've got the single, my album that I'm working on, getting ready for the movie.
She also headlines a national tour that includes the show's 10 finalists and second place finisher, Justin Guarini.
Coming in second place, I mean, losing per se, like, it doesn't matter. It really doesn't. Hey, you know, I've been beamed into a million homes singing a song for a minute and a half, you know what I mean? If I get to do it once, that's good enough, because, you know, X amount of people are going to see me, and somebody somewhere is going to like me.
Just as losing a talent contest didn't seem to impede Justin Timberlake's career, coming in second hasn't been bad for Justin Guarini, either.
It's all right with me.
He also got a record deal and is signed to appear in a movie with Clarkson.
Justin Timberlake didn't win the Star Search, and I don't think Britney did. I just don't think it makes a difference. What paid off for them is persistency.
What pays off for viewers is the feeling that they were in on the discovery.
Congratulations, America. You made this happen. You have found your idol.
Talent contests make show business a temporary democracy. It gives the audience a share of someone's success and celebrity, which, as the veterans know, is one of the most important ingredients of the formula.
Well, I think the audience rallies to that. There you are. You're in on it. And people love to have bragging rights.
A moment like this, some people wait a lifetime.
As many doors as I have had slammed in my face, many people telling me, you know, it won't happen because of this, it won't happen because of this. It did happen, and I do have my foot in the door.